Greetings. There once was a young boy. One day his parents took him to the airport to pick up his grandma. While there, he saw a crowd waiting, and the doors opened in front of the crowd, and the crowd erupted in cheers and clapping, and men with only one arm came walking out. Some men were on crutches and had only one leg. Some men were in chairs with wheels. Some of those men had no legs at all. And the boy asked his father a question. "Why are the people cheering, father?" Now, the father had just seen the grandmother and did not want a lengthy discussion. "Those men are heroes, son. There's your grandma. We need to go." And the holidays passed, and the boy kept remembering what he had seen. And school began again, and the need for school sports. But the boy hated sports. He was small for his age and a poor athlete. Feeling sad, the boy went to see the school counselor. "So how are you today, and what do you want to discuss, young man?" "I feel very sad," the boy said. "You can tell me anything," the counselor said. "This office is your safe space." "I can't. I'm afraid you'll tell my mom and dad." "Oh, no," the counselor said. "They will never know what we discuss." And with very encouraging and supportive words, repeated many times, the boy began to speak. "I'm terrible at sports. I don't like them. And I have given this lots of thought. I do not think I'm supposed to have two legs. I want to have my leg removed."
"That is a very serious thing to do, young man. Are you sure?"
"You said you would help me."
And the boy began to cry, so desperate his emotional state. And the counselor, fresh from the annual conference on body acceptance, began the paperwork to help the boy transition from C body to R body. The counselor had learned the word normal was a trigger word and too emotionally offensive. The term C body had been chosen to mean two-arm, two-leg, classically assumed human appendage configuration. The term R body meant real body, the body a human was really meant to have as an individual. And so, without consulting parents, the process was begun. The boy would be helped by the counselor at the school. Months passed, and the boy was included in a special class. It was to train him how to use crutches and the other needs he would soon have. The boy was excited because it got him out of PE, or physical extermination, as he called it. Under the auspices and deception of summer school, the boy was taken to the transition center for the procedure. The trip required him to fly to the transition center. 3 months later, the boy returned with his procedure largely healed. As the plane landed, he was so excited. His procedure now required him to be the last off the plane. His excitement built. Finally, the steward brought him his new crutches, and he walked off the plane. And when he walked off the plane, he was surprised. There was no cheering crowd, no shouting, no banners, no clapping. Only his mother and father, his mother in tears, his father silent with his head hung.
"Where are the people, Daddy?" the boy asked.
"What people, son?"
"Where are the people to cheer the heroes, Daddy? When we got Grandma, people cheered the men and women with no arms and no legs. I just wanted to be a hero, Daddy."
And the father and the mother were devastated. The system had been created so the amputation of their boy's leg was not in their control. Once the boy truly experienced the added difficulties of his disability, he grew sadder and sadder.
He wanted to go back. He wanted his leg back. He wanted to run again, even badly.
But he could never go back. A boy, too young for anything in society, too young to vote, too young to smoke, too young to drink alcohol, too young to buy a movie ticket to a PG-13 movie. Such a boy could choose to amputate a body part that would forever change his life. Perhaps you understand the moral. Right now, America is beginning to allow boys to amputate their before the boy's brain is even fully formed enough
to legally allow them to make less important decisions. Parental consent and support for the amputation is not even the point. Courts remove parental control when parental decision threatens the life of the child. If amputating healthy body parts is not a threat to the healthy, normal life of their child, may the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.